Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. 1 Samuel 20:14-19. But show me unfailing kindness like the Lord's kindness as long as I live, so that I may not be killed, and do not ever cut off your kindness from my family, not even when the Lord has cut off every one of David's enemies from the face of the earth. So Jonathan made a covenant with the house of David, saying, May the Lord call David's enemies to account. And Jonathan had David reaffirm his oath out of love for him, because he loved him as he loved himself. Then Jonathan said to David, Tomorrow is the new moon feast. You will be missed, because your seat will be empty. The day after tomorrow, toward evening, go to the place where you hid when this trouble began, and wait by the stone Ezel. Today's title is What a Friend We Have. People's relationship with others is often very self-centered. Most people want to get self-satisfaction through different relationships with others. To a certain extent, we understand it and accept it as human nature. We would not complain about it as long as the relationship is mutually beneficial. We may call it a fair relationship. But we often discover what seemed like a fair relationship or fair deal indeed was not. Jonathan's relationship with David was pure. His love for David was not based on any selfish considerations. It was a love sparked and spurred by God. Having seen how passionately David loved God and how valiantly David fought for God and his people, Jonathan instantly loved God. His love for David got only deepened as he saw God's anointing on David more clearly despite Saul's jealousy and hatred against David. Jonathan's love for David is a foreshadowing of Christ's love for us. Christ called us his friend. I no longer call you servants, because a servant does not know his master's business. Instead, I have called you friends, for everything that I learned from my Father I have made known to you, John 15:15. Jesus also said greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. John 15:13. With that, Jesus gave the new commandment to love each other. My command is this, love each other as I have loved you. John 15:12. Jesus indeed laid down his life for us as a true friend. He wants us to share the same selfless love with each other. I believe Jonathan was exactly doing what Jesus told us. He was laying down his life for David out of true love. He tells David to do the same for him and his family. Neither Jonathan nor David was seeking his own selfish gain. They covenanted that they would act out of love for each other under any circumstance. Both Jonathan and David kept this covenant of love. What a godly and lovely relationship they had. Wonderful. But do not just envy Jonathan and David for their beautiful relationship. You can have an even better relationship if you are a friend of Jesus. Jonathan died for a good friend like David. But Jesus died for a wretched like us when we were still sinners. Did you receive such wonderful love from Jesus, the Son of God? Then you can truly sing What a Friend We Have in Jesus from the bottom of your heart. Amen.